This is a new and exciting product being sold in places like Tesco in the UK. Now, Tesco is a large supermarket chain, and for the mere price of £3, you can get a disposable charger for Android or a version for Apple. The Android version has a micro USB connector. The Apple has the proprietary Apple connector on it. And the idea is that when you buy this for about £3, you simply take it out of the packet, turn it on, plug it into your phone. Hold on, I've got a phone here I could plug it into. Is it going to reach with this case? I'll just wipe the dust off the phone. So let's plug this in. And hopefully that will power up. I don't think that's reached the connect. Oh, there it goes. There it goes. It does. So basically speaking, it contains a fixed portion of power that you can use to charge your phone up. And it is, unfortunately, disposable. And this is a bit of a crime because when you pop the lid in it, well, let's pop the lid in this one. Let's compare them because I've already had one of these open and done some experiments on it. Oop. So the lithium battery inside, because it is a little lithium battery, is stuck in with sort of goo on both sides. And it's got a little boost circuit. Now, interestingly, here's an interesting thing. The other one also has a broken inductor. They've both got little inductors that... I wonder if that's deliberate. They've broken some of the material off this, the ferrite material. That's strange. But the circuitry is very, very simple. You've got a little 6-pin chip, and I have to say, I did not find this chip online, unless I was just looking the wrong direction, but the chip is called a 27T111. And there's very little support circuitry. There's the inductor, and there are 1, 2, 3 little capacitors just for presumably filtering and, you know, holding the slight... For the frequency this is running at, for putting acting as a small reservoir capacitor. The cell itself is called HKT702535P, 3.7 volt, which suggests it's lithium ion, and it's rated 600 milliamp hour. And keep in mind that this is designed to be used once and then binned, which is just an apocalypse. Because the cell, to all intents and purposes, appears to be rechargeable. And to test that, I also bought an e-cig, an electronic cigarette, with one of these universal chargers on it. And I opened it up, measured the voltage, which was a bit of a naughty voltage. It was 4.27, it was quite high. And I discharged one of these cells completely, and then put it across this charger circuitry in here, soldered it on, and gave it a full charge, and it has taken the full charge. So these do appear to be rechargeable lithium cells, but in a product that is designed to be used once and then thrown away. And, you know, that seems incredibly wasteful. It is incredibly wasteful. But I guess that ultimately it's the cheapest way to do it, because this contains a lithium ion cell is cheap to make. It's mass produced. The materials in it are not that significant. I mean, you've got a copper foil, you've got an aluminium foil, you've got this sort of graphite type coatings, and then a very, very tiny trace amount of lithium in there. So ecologically, I suppose it's a cheap way of doing it, but it seems wasteful that something that could have been charged about 1,000 times is being used in a one-off disposable product, complete with a sort of boost converter circuit. It would have been nice to add this tiny amount of circuitry and space that would have been involved just to be able to plug a micro USB into this and charge up again and make a tiny little power bank. Particularly given that this is rated 600 milliamp hour, but it's having to be boosted, so you're not going to get that in the 5 volts out to charge. You're probably going to get 400 or 500 milliamp hour actual 5 volt charging capability. The connector is nice and deep. Well, I say it's nice and deep. It's nice and deep once you remove it from the product. Because that is a very, very deep connector. And it's mounted quite securely in the circuit board. It's got 3 connections in this side and 2 connections in that side. And interestingly, they've actually bridged the middle connection from one of these pins. I'm not sure which pin that is. Is that not one of the data lines it's bridging onto? Because I thought that if they were bridging, I'm guessing they've got one connection soldered this side. I'm guessing that might be the micro USB identification pin, But it seems odd that they've also bridged onto one of the data, what I think is the data pin in the middle, on the other side. Odd. I'm finding it a bit perplexing that the little inductors have had a bit, you know, it looks like they've had a bit broken off, because it's a different shape. It's as if it's either during manufacturing something snapped the top of that inductor, or they've snapped it deliberately for some to change the inductance in some way. I'm not really sure. But yes, it seems kind of a waste, doesn't it? But on the other hand, this cell, which does not have any protection, it doesn't need any protection because it's not designed to be charged, but it is an unprotected 600 milliamp hour cell for £3 from your local Tesco in the UK with a little bonus boost circuit. So it's actually maybe worth getting just for the components. But for a single charge and then throwing in the bin, it's really not worth getting, because in that perspective, it's a bit of an ecological disaster.